All right, first question is from Red Surf Bus. Is it better to drop a rep and increase weight by a larger amount or progress with smaller fractional plates?
Either. They're both good. Now, here's the thing. Have you guys ever experimented with adding a quarter to a half pound in your workouts on an incremental slow basis? Mm-hmm. What was your guys' experience with that?
It's a very smart strategy. Most people don't have the patience to do it, but it's actually a great strategy.
I think that's the key there. It's like you have to be patient and you have to like be proactively like doing that. Like every workout, you're thinking about that. And like, I don't know, I went through a phase where I did that and it did, you know, pay off for me, but it felt like more of a struggle to do.
Now, the problem is that the plates that you get now, conventional plates, don't go lower than 2.5 pounds. So that means if you add one on each side, you're going up by 5 pounds, which sounds small, but it's still a substantial amount to go up. But at one point, I used to have these collars that you put on the sides of the bar, and the collars themselves weighed like, you know, half a pound or whatever. And so I'd go up by like a pound at a time. Mm. That really was actually quite remarkable. I got pretty good results by doing that. But anyway, to answer the question,
I think there's value both ways here.
Yeah, totally. Either way, you're adding weight, you're adding volume in the form of adding weight to your workouts. It's progressive resistance regardless of how you do it. Both ways have total value.
I think something like if I really got into like something like powerlifting, I would totally like apply this method like more and be more detailed, because I'm writing down like very specifically like each time I'm trying to progress, and I'm writing down my results and then what I've added on, you know, like even if it's fractional, I'm adding that on. So it totally adds up over time.
Mm-hmm. People always want us to tell them what is better, this or that. And
usually it's either
right,
or both.
It's almost always that, right? I'm trying to think of a case when it hasn't been. I mean, there's some examples, I guess, that are very obvious and extreme. But for the most part, like it's rarely ever an either or. It's, you know, it whichever one that you probably do most of the time, the other one is super beneficial at that point, because your body has got used to that and adapted to that. So doing something different is going to add more value. So, and both have value. So I think why this is part of what annoys me about our space is that, you know, you take something and you could separate this, right? We could totally separate these two things.
You create two camps immediately.
Right. We could do a study. We could go for 6 weeks and we could show this and control all these things and go like, oh, well, it looks like that the group A that incrementally went up, you know, gained, you know, 1% more strength than group B. Yeah. But the truth is, if group A continues on doing the same thing as group A forever, then switching things up and being group B would actually probably be the most beneficial thing. So, and that kind of falls suit, I think, with almost everything we discuss.
Now that being said, just to be completely honest, I don't know what this is, but I rarely ever add anything under 20 or 50 pounds on the bar when I want to go up. I just don't like adding small plates. Maybe it's an ego thing. I don't know.
I get caught up in that too. So I know we're not alone with that. It's just one of those things. You just kind of like pick your next amount, and sometimes 20, something. You just know how, you know, you can ramp it up based on the feeling of where you're at.
The smallest amount is 20 pounds, which is not small. That's a big jump.
Yeah, it is a big jump.
And what I do is I wait till my reps get high.
Yeah.
And then I say, oh, I can add 20 pounds, and I slap, you know, 20 pounds.
We used to say, so if for chest, back, and legs, okay, so your big muscle groups, like you're not allowed to do anything less than a quarter. That was like
was the only way.
Tens and fives were for arms, bro.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
Like if somebody went out,
so
and
stupid.
Got, yeah, if somebody slid a 10 on a squat, it'd be we'd laugh at each other and be like,
pure,
you can't do
pure
that.
Ego.
Yeah.
No,
that's
but
totally wrong.
But to be honest, it's smarter to incrementally add weight.
Sure.
You know, you don't necessarily. I mean, I never did with clients. I never trained clients where I'm like, oh, looks like you're stronger, let's add 50 pounds. Like, I never did that. I did that to myself because, you know, as a trainer, I train other people better than I train myself. So, but yeah, either one can definitely have value. Do the one that you haven't been doing. So if you tend to add larger amounts, go to the fractional adding of the weight. If you tend to do the fractional one, which is probably more rare, then I'd say go the other direction.